morning, we are bringing you all the glamour, the gongs and the gowns from the Golden Globe Awards. Angela Bishop is live from the red carpet in Los Angeles. But before we cross to her, you better meet our fantastic panel for the morning. Back for another week of fun is James Matheson. He's filling it for Joe.
I'm here for the frocks. I'm here for the frocks, ladies.
As well, a big warm welcome to Jamila Rizvi. She is the editor-in-chief of the Mamma Mia Women's Network.
I'm here for James.
You'd be the only one.
Of course, adding decorum and style to our panel, as always, Jess and Arthur. Yeah. And even Jono's weaseled his way onto the panel this morning because it's Monday, yes. Which means it's time for Jono to call up his favourite moments in history.
Absolutely. Roll the bumper.
Roll up, read all about it. It happened this week-ish.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Hello, everybody.
Hi, mate.
Hi, Jono.
Well, you know what? For people like myself and I, who like a small drink, in moderation, of course, in 1920, before either of us were born, luckily, prohibition started in America. It didn't work very well, so they got rid of it after a while. But remember all these amazing signs and scenes of in Chicago, especially, and in New York, all that booze being destroyed by the feds. And, of course, in that time, they had all those gangsters, and Al Capone was one of them. And there was a great movie that you may or may not have seen, the TV show The Untouchables with Robert Stack, but also the movie of The Untouchables, directed by, this is it, Brian De Palma, Kevin Costner, an amazing movie. Mm. All sorts of people. That Sean Connery was an Irish cop. Kevin Costner and Robert De Niro as Al Capone. If you've never seen that movie, do yourself a favour. It's just come out on Blu-ray again, but it is absolutely fantastic. Brian De Palma. They all changed their look so much. Have you seen that, Sarah?
No, but I was just saying, hey, it's a bit of a getting your mind around the fact that, you know, booze. I mean, it's such
throwing away alcohol. Yeah, yeah. Just, no, still recovering from that.
But it's a huge part of our social fabric these days here in Australia.
And there was such a big anti-drinking movement in America. They just decided in 1920 bring in prohibition. Didn't last.
My great aunt lived in America during prohibition, and she had a recipe for making gin in the bathtub.
I'll get that from.
I'm
later
keeping
on.
It in the family. I buy it in the bottle now.
Also on this week in history, 1971. All in the Family made its debut in America with Carol O'Connor as Archie Bunker. Wow. And, of course, it was the spin-off, one of the first formats that was sold from the English TV show with Warren Mitchell. Have a look at this version of All in the Family or on the Warren Mitchell version. I'm not sure which one we got first. Oh, that's
the
American
one. This here is the struggle of the races. Man's inhumanity to man.
I'm all alone here. I'm all alone in this house.
Fantastic version, that is. That's the American version of All in the Family, which came from the British version, which was Till Death Us Do Part with Warren Mitchell, which was fantastic as well. And they sold that format. And the young boy in that was actually, well, a young boy, but it was Rob Reiner, who's a film director in his own right now. But there's Warren Mitchell playing the original English version.
They ruled the seven seas, and anything found on them was ours, mate, ours!
And that's Cherie Blair's dad playing the young man. That's Cherie Booth, and that's her dad playing the part in that part. So anyway, that looked fantastic. There he is there. Mm. You silly old moo. Okay, my dad's favourite show. God rest his soul. He's up there with Warren Mitchell, but he's still alive. 1979, the Village People were threatened by a lawsuit because of their song The YMCA. And the YMCA themselves didn't like the fact because there was connotations. How could we have ever thought there was a gay influence in that, in the Village People? We were so blind. The Village People and YMCA, the lawsuit was dropped, and YMCA became the biggest selling song ever for the Village People, sold over 10 million copies. Very big in Australia and New Zealand. Marvellous stuff. And having a birthday today, the fabulous Jim Carrey, of course, from The Truman Show, directed by the Australian Peter Weir. So happy birthday to him. He's going to be 53 this week. Julia Louis-Dreyfus from one of my favourite shows, Seinfeld, and currently can be seen on Veep, all about the Vice President. And having a birthday tomorrow, turning Australian, Al Dillon, as far as I'm concerned, Paul Kelly, from Little Things, Big Things Grow. He'll be turning 60 tomorrow, so happy birthday if you're sharing a birthday. Those are just some of the things that happened in history this week.
Thanks.
I'm going to have one of Ita's gins now.
We're all caught up. Thanks, Jono.